Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to learn and interact together. We are going to have our biology form 3 lesson 24, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. This lesson we are going to deal on the topic on reproduction in plants and animals, and the subtopic whereby we are going to introduce reproduction in plants and animals. We are going to have a lesson goal whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to give the importances of reproduction. Let us be keen on the lesson such that we'll be able to answer any question on reproduction. In the introduction part of reproduction in plants and animals, we can say that the process by which mature individuals produce offspring is called reproduction. Reproduction is an essential characteristic of all living organisms. Basically, there are two types of reproduction, which are based on the ability of the cell to divide and form new daughter cells. We have the the sexual and asexual reproduction, as well is being represented by the diagrams there. So we have the sexual and the asexual. The sexual reproduction involves the fusion of the male and the female gametes to form a zygote. The fusion of the nuclei of the male and the female gametes is known as fertilization. Asexual reproduction, as you can see from our screen, does not involve gametes. Instead, parts of the mature organisms may develop to form new individuals, as you are seeing from our screens. Now, I would like us to look at the importances of reproduction, because everything has got its own importance. The first importance of reproduction is that it is used in for procreation. Reproduction sustains or perpetuates the species so that does not become extinct. Since no living organism lives forever, every species must produce new individuals, or what we call the offspring, in order for the species to continue. Another importance of reproduction is for quality improvement. It improves the quality of the species. Reproductions allow mixing of genetic materials, which leads to variations among individuals in a species. This is observed in sexual reproduction. The variations form the basis for adaptability in their habitats. Having introduced the reproduction in plants and animals, we can now go forward and look at what we call cell division. Because this cell division is the one that involves reproduction. Life in living organisms starts as a single cell, as a spore or as a zygote. In multicellular organisms, the cell divides into two and continues to divide in the same way. In unicellular organisms, such as the amoeba, the cell divides into two separate daughter cells. The cell division starts with division of the nucleus, that is the chromosomes and the cytoplasm. Like us, we can have a diagrammatic representation of a chromosome, whereby in the nucleus, there are a number of long thread-like structures called the chromosomes, which is being represented on our screen. Each cell normally has a fixed number of chromosomes. Each chromosome is made up of two parallel strands called chromatin, the chromatids. In singular is known as a chromatid, as you can see from our screen. Each pair of chromatid is connected at one point by a structure known as the centromere, which is being visible from our screen. Chromosomes are present in the nucleus all the time, but they only appear or become visible when viewed under a microscope during cell division. In body cells, chromosomes occur in pairs. Each pair of chromosomes has a characteristic length. The member of each pair is called an homologous chromosome. This means that the chromosomes are alike in appearance, although their genetic composition may be different. During sexual reproduction, each parent contributes one of the chromosomes from a homologous pair. Along the length of the chromosome is a series of structures called genes. They are too small to be seen even with a powerful microscope. They determine the characteristics of the cell and its progeny. Genes are made of a protein chemical substance called the DNA, whereby the DNA in full is the deoxyribonucleic acid, which contains coded information of instructions that dictate the characteristic of the offspring. For example, whether male or female. Young cells of an organism divide actively and grow before they differentiate into tissues and organs. The ability of cells to divide is located in specific areas where the cells are unspecialized. These include the meristematic cambium cells, the meristematic apical cells in the woody plants and in the Malpighian layer in the mammalian skin. The sequence of events leading to cell division in plant and animals is basically the same. There are two types of cell division, which include the cell mitosis and meiosis. That one we are going to look in our next lesson, so ensure that you are updated. We are going to have an activity whereby you will be required to draw and label the structure of the chromosome. For this lesson and more, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 3, which is the 4th edition Nairobi, and it has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And for this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you can also subscribe to our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you send you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels so that we might enjoy more of our biology lessons. Thank you.